H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Name. What does it mean? Let me write the third point. Firefox driver is a class. I'm repeating. Let me write down the point. See. Firefox driver is a class. Implements web driver interface. Okay, so if a class which is implementing an interface, then we can write as interface reference variable is equal to interface variable is equal to new class name. That is the logic. Okay, so this is valid in Java. Again, I'm telling you, web driver is an interface. Okay, then Firefox driver is a class. Okay, web driver is an interface means web driver contains 100% abstract methods. Okay, these abstract methods are going to be implemented by some class. So Firefox driver is a class which is implementing this web driver interface. Okay, so if any class which is implementing an web driver interface, any web driver interface, then we can write as interface reference variable is equal to new class name means web driver driver is equal to new Firefox driver. Okay, are you able to get it, everyone? If you have any doubt, let me know. I'll repeat it again because this is a very important point. The first line you say ABC, this is the A, the first point. Okay, so this is the one. Every program from today onwards, whatever I write, the first line of statement is web driver driver is equal to new Firefox driver. This is the first line of statement. So you have to remember, okay, then you have to recollect, remember and recollect that Firefox driver is a class, web driver is an interface, Firefox driver is a class which is implementing this web driver interface. That's the reason I'm writing like this. Okay, yes, good. Okay, good point. Okay, where is this interface is defined? Where is this class is defined? If you see, there is an error. If you see, there is an error red mark. It is saying that you try to import the package where this interface is defined, where this class is defined. Right? You have to import. This is the logic we do, right? Suppose, for example, in the case of file, what is a package I import? java.io.file. Suppose for example I use linked list, what is the package I import? java.util. Suppose for example if I use integer class, java.lang, that's a default package. Even if you don't import, it is not an issue. So importing packages are very important because this web driver is an interface available in some package, right? So we know the shortcut. How do you organize imports? How do you organize imports? What is the shortcut for that? I already told you so many times. What is a shortcut for organizing the imports? Control Shift O. Okay, O can be, O is smaller. Okay, you need to type bigger. Okay, uppercase. Just a Control Shift O. That's it. You don't need to bother. When I say Control Shift O, it is saying that WebDriver is an interface available in the package org.openqa.selenium. Okay, openqa.selenium. So at least you have to remember the package name because we are trying to use Java from so many days. So we can easily remember java.io for IO operations, java.util for linked list and all these things. So, but what is the package in Selenium WebDriver? org.openqa.selenium is a package which contains a WebDriver interface. At least you have to remember one package name just for our understanding. Okay. Just for understanding, org.openqa.selenium okay, and org.opengrr selenium.firefox, that is for the Firefox driver class. Okay, I'm done. I have written the first line of statement. What I'm going to do right now, see what happens when you write WebDriver driver is equal to new Firefox driver. When you write WebDriver driver is equal to new Firefox driver, it will try to open a one Firefox browser. Again, when you write WebDriver driver is equal to new Firefox browser, Firefox driver, it will open one Firefox browser, and driver has a focus on that browser. The web driver has a focus on it. Okay, so let me execute this program. When I execute this program, what happens? See, I execute the program. It's asking for Java application. So I executed. Actually, when you try to execute the program, it will take at least 1 or 2 minutes to open the Firefox browser. Okay, so you can check the console also. I'll show the console. See, I'll double click on the console. So it'll show any information. If there is an issue in opening the browser, it will show the logs here. Okay, so it will take some time. Still, it is not at open. Once it is open, I'll let you know. This is not the one. Let it open. This I open manually. Let the Firefox opens by the program. I think it will take at least 2-3 minutes of time. Depends upon the speed of your laptop also. Hello, are you able to hear me? Okay, cool, fine. I think what I mean to say is it will take some time. Sometimes it will try to take now 2 minutes or 3 minutes, depends upon the speed of your laptop. Okay, so we have to wait. Things still not at open. Let it open. Okay, I'll show the program once, because anyway it is taking time to open. Please focus on this program. Any doubts, type in the chart window so that I can proceed with the next line. Meanwhile, let it open. So I think it opened. Everybody is able to see, right? It opened on Firefox browser, right? But everybody is able to see, right? But if you see, the address is blank. I didn't mention what address URL or what URL you want me to open. I didn't mention that. I just mentioned open a Firefox browser. Open a Firefox browser. But if you want to open this browser with a URL, particular URL, we have to write as driver.get, and we have to pass the URL, which URL you want to use to open this browser. Again, I'm saying, when I say web driver, driver is equal to new Firefox driver, it will open a browser. Just listen, actually people have an idea, people have an understanding that when I say driver.get, the browser will be open. No, when you say web driver, driver is equal to new Firefox driver, at that point only browser will be opened. But if you want to open the browser with a particular URL, say google.com, so I have to write as, see, driver.get, I have to pass the URL. When you try to pass the URL, you have to mention specifically HTTP. If you mention www.google.com, it will not work. You have to mention what kind of protocol. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. You have to mention whether it is a HTTP or HTTPS, clearly mention it, then only the browser will open with that URL. Otherwise, the browser will be opened only, the URL will not be loaded. Google.com. Again, I'm saying people, a lot of people does the same mistake. HTTP is very important. If you miss it, it will open the browser, but it will not load that URL. Now what happens? I'll do one thing. Let me execute this program. Okay. I'm closing the Firefox again. I'm running the program again. See how to run the program? See here, say run Google text. Let it run. What happens? Let's see. It will take 2 to 3 minutes of time. Let it open. Yes. Suppose for example, I want to open Facebook. Okay. Facebook, if you are able to open using HTTP, you have to give http://www.facebook.com. Okay. Let it open. I'm opening the console to see whether any error messages are coming. I open console also to check whether any messages are coming. So I think what I'm trying to do is I'll try to execute by writing few more commands. Then I'll take a control of everybody's laptop and I'll help you today. Okay. Because I want to do the setup, everything ready for the next class. So I'll try to spend time today, more time to resolve issues and try to make it working in everybody's laptop. So it will be ready for the next session properly. Okay. Okay. From here, I'm opening console Payal. Okay. Let's see. Suppose for example, I by mistake, I close the console. Okay. See, go to window. You can check if you are able to open, if you open Eclipse, check, follow the same steps as similar to me. Go to window, show view, click on console. Again, I'm saying window, show view, click on console. If the console is not showing here, then you have to go to other and type console. If it is not showing the list, okay, and it will show in the general part, select console, say okay. Okay, that's it. I think still Firefox not at open, because what happens is there's a concept in the case of profiles, okay, for Firefox. I'll explain afterwards, but let it open. I think it opened Firefox and it is showing the URL also. Okay. So www.http://www.google.com I gave, but it is showing as https://www.google.co.in. Okay. There's a small question I'll ask you here. The Firefox opens with the URL. It opens a google.com. Fine. There's a small point here. I'll explain you just for understanding purpose, not for Selenium perspective. I am trying to give google.com, but when it opens, it is showing google.co.in. So what is the reason behind it? Anybody knows why it is showing instead of google.com, it is showing. So what is the reason? Okay, fine. So fine. So what happens here is when the request comes from any location, it will try to check from which location it is coming and try to redirect the request to the particular server located nearby location. So we'll get that URL. This we called as server redirection. Okay. So this is a concept in the HTTP. Server redirection happens. Okay. This is called a server redirection. Okay. Fine. Yes, server redirection happens now. So I am able to open the browser. Now, if you see the title, anybody see the title of the page? What's the title of the Google page? The title of the Google page, you can find it here. The title of the Google page is Google, capital G-O-O-G-L-E. What is the title of the Google page? Capital G-O-O-G-L-E. So, I have a test case to check the title of the page. As a manual tester, I open the browser, I enter the URL, I check the test, check the Google manually. But I already automated two steps. What are the two steps I automated? Open the browser, enter this URL. The third step, what I have to automate? To get the title. So whatever the manual tester is doing, I am doing as automation tester. What I am doing now, I need to get the title of this page. How to get the title of this page? Let's see. Okay. If you want to get the title of the page, which is called Google in this scenario, we have to call a method called driver.getTitle. What is the method? Driver.getTitle is the method we have to call in this scenario. Okay. One more point. When I place a mouse pointer on get, what is the return type of this method? How do you recognize methods? I told you recognizing the methods happens using parentheses. Here there's a parenthesis. Right? And get is a non-static method. GetTitle is a non-static method because using objects we can call non-static methods. That's what we are doing now also. Fine. Now I am placing a mouse pointer on get. Can anybody tell me what is the return type of the get method? I am placing mouse pointer. I want return type of the get method. Let's place mouse pointer on the get method. What is the return type of the get method? What is the return type of the get method? Again, the return type of the get method is void. So when the method is returning void, see if you see here. So anybody who is not following, just see here. You see the void thing. This is the return type. Means methods which are returning anything or which are not returning anything, it's called void. So we never store any value which returns by void. But let's see in the get title. Let's place a mouse pointer on get title. What is the get title is returning? Get title is returning a string. So if it is returning a string, so we have to store that value in a string only. So what I have to do now? See, I have to store the value in a string. See, string title is equal to driver dot get title. So what is the content of the title? How do we check the content of the title? We have to print that title and see the content of the title. So in the runtime, it will go and open the browser and it will enter the URL and it will get the title and it will store in the title variable and try to print it. That's what it happens. Okay, that's what it happens. So let me print this now. Let me print the title. How to print the tint title? We use a system dot out dot println to print the title. See, okay. Title is title. Okay, so when you try to run, what happens? The browser will be opened, the URL will be entered, the title will be returned and it will be printed as Google. Okay, I'm explaining one more point here, the most important point. You are trying to open the browser with the URL google.com. What is a guarantee that the page is opened successfully? The guarantee that the page is opened successfully is whenever you are able to fetch the title as Google, that means the page is loaded successfully. If the page is not loaded successfully, you will not get title. So what is the confirmation that page is successfully opened in the real-time scenarios? If the title is able to get it, if you are able to fetch the title of the page, then see that page is opened successfully. That's the understanding. Okay, that's understanding. Okay, fine. So how many methods we have seen? Can anybody tell me what are the method names and how many methods we have seen now? We have seen two methods, get and get title. Get method takes a URL as a string. Get title doesn't take any arguments but returns a string as a return type. So we have seen two methods. Okay, we are just invoking the methods. So we'll focus on few more methods. Let's see few more methods. I'll try to write few more methods for understanding. Let's see.